There's just some things in life you'll want to root out early on. Of course, the best strategy to prevent weeds is to plant something better. That way it won't be able to grow, but it's not always possible. So here's a temporary strategy. Yep, found a crazy squirrel in my garden. Been a while since I had one get in the garden, which is a good thing because last year I had a chili relleno plant, which I was hoping to make some homemade chili rellenos from, and they ate my plant. I joked around and used to call the plant my Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Heart Club plant, and darn squirrels ate my Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Heart Club plant. Wasn't too happy about that, but here it is. Another squirrel in my yard. I seen him poke his head up in between the rocks, and he's hiding in the rocks, so what are you gonna do? I had bought a squirrel cage at one time, and then I researched it and realized they're not legal to capture them and release them somewhere else, so I actually had to return it. I did make a video on that, but you know. Anyway, now I've since kind of closed this section off of the garden, but I need to put some kind of gate or something across it. There he goes. That little booger ate my jalapeno. I didn't eat my broccoli. No one likes the broccoli. So you might remember the bulls that got in my backyard that I did a video on, showed you guys. And they basically treated my garden like it was a smorgasbord buffet. They just basically sampled every last wildflower and every last thing in the garden. The only thing they didn't touch was my broccoli. Seems like no one likes a broccoli. And I guess I have to confess, even I didn't eat my broccoli. It went to flowers. I got broccoli going, yay. Well, looks like I waited too long to pick the broccoli. It all flowered. Broccoli flowers. When I had the bull get in the backyard, it's the one thing they didn't eat was the broccoli. Bulls don't like broccoli.